Hello and welcome back. Sol here. I'm very glad to have you back. Today we have Hammerman attacking our island, which is amazing. I told you many times that I enjoy this event a lot. It's one of my favorite just because since the beginning, the level of my troops were not very good. So I have to make do with what I had and maximize what I had. So there was this sort of an puzzle solving aspect of it, which I enjoyed. So we're going to go ahead and load our... Oh, we're going to have to clear some trees before. Pretty sure of that. Let's see. Maybe we don't. Let's double check. Let's load our circle base, our left aligned circle base. All right, so just that tree is out. That's good. So let's load our left aligned circle base and go for it. Oh, actually, before we do that, let me move our... Before we do that, right now, I'm on stage 58 of the Mega Crab. I just did an initial attack with Scorchers, clear everything out. So this should fall in the next attack once my troop load. And then in terms of the local United States, I'm at 627, which is pretty good. I actually climbed last night to 387 once I finished all my attacks. So maybe I will climb a little bit more. So if you're interested, there's going to be a playlist on the upper right corner, a little icon you can see. All my attacks, I've recorded all of them except one where the replay failed. So yeah, take a look into it. So for my base, I would put a description on the, I would put in the description what's the average level and the of my defenses and what's the percentage of completion. I didn't calculate it beforehand, so I apologize for that. But I did increase all the level of my cannons one level up, and of the boom cannons, I did increase two of them to level 13. So now I have four level 13 cannons. Five level 18 cannons, one level 17, and then four level 13 boom cannons and one level 12. So yeah, we have our base loaded, and let's go for it. Let's see what happens. Where's Hammerman? Where are you, man? Here we go. So he's gonna attack us with 12 heavies and 144 riflemen. This, based on our experience, it shouldn't be any problem. So he's attacking our rocket launcher initially. Yeah, last week it was crazy, guys. That last stage took me so much. 27 attempts, if I'm not mistaken. But I did finally manage to beat him. Because he was doing a lot of barrage. He was destroying boom cannons, two rocket launchers. So I had to really work hard to get that one. I hope this today is not as hard. I do like a challenge, but not as hard as the last time. So stage one wasn't that bad. I didn't check how many guys. Wait a second, with riflemen, medics, tanks, and Sukas, if I'm not mistaken. Or maybe grenadiers. So here you see groups are clustering up on the first sort of building, which is amazing because now they're all going to walk as a group through that minefield, and those Sukas are going to get destroyed. Let's crash that. The riflemen are gonna get destroyed. Oh, warriors! He's attacking up with warriors. Okay, even better. The buildings, the idea for that grouping building came for the, because I was getting attacked a lot by warriors in one of the stages. And you can see, out of the entire warriors, maybe there was eight left when all was said and done. So yeah, we know Hammerman doesn't stand a chance. He's gonna start walking on the right side. And those tanks are going to get destroyed by the rocket launchers on the left side. For those of you who are new to my channel, that haven't seen this base before, the idea behind this is that you divide the troops and you control the timing and flow. So you're going to get a right group and a left group. The left group, you want to guide the big, the most massive amount of troops that you have. So that way, and their guys on the right are going to take his sweet time going around like the tanks are doing. And then you give time for your defenses to isolate a specific group and then target it and destroy it before your defenses get overwhelmed. Because most of the time, you lose because your defenses get overwhelmed. You don't lose because your defenses don't have enough power. It's just that your defenses get overwhelmed. So that was stage three. Power rods are always very welcome. I'm always using them. yeah, Hammerman, I know. So let's see what he attacked it with. So he attacked us with 9 tanks, 24 riflemen, 48 sukas, and 64 warriors. All right, so let's go to stage three. Now, you may notice that I don't have anything upgrading right now. My upgrade finished around 3 in the morning, and I didn't want to wake up to add another upgrade. But also, because whenever you start a new upgrade, Hammerman retargets your defenses. So if anything like last week happens where he was targeting both my rocket launchers, then I'll start a boom cannon upgrade or a cannon upgrade. And that's going to force him to rethink what structures he's going to target with GV. So he's sending barrage to the back. Don't care about it. Now you're seeing the split. When you have medics, the split is lovely. You know, it's awesome. Mainly because the medics are going to go back and forth. And usually when that happens, they don't tend to heal what they should be healing. So you see right now, you get one medic, you get all those heavies really damaged on that side. And those medics are going to bail. Those medics are going to bail from the guys on the front. And they're going to start heading towards the heavies on the right side. And when they do, then you can kill whatever's in front of you better. But right now, the troops are getting overwhelmed with my defenses. They have no chance. So the medics, actually, everything just got destroyed on that side. So I'm going to accelerate. I'm going to accelerate this as fast as I can. And then let it go. Like, this is the only bad part. Usually, you have to wait. Because the troops on the right side of the map take a little bit longer to complete their approach. So usually you see that rocket launcher, this rocket launcher that's right here, I usually have it inside the cluster for the highest stages. It's right there just to make the first few stages faster. Ooh, come on. You're supposed to be here making an S. All right. Let's see what else he's bringing. So we're now on stage four. We're cruising, guys. We're cruising. So 20 grenadiers, 12 medics, 216 riflemen, 32 warriors, and 36 sukas. Now, somebody told me that the order in which they appear here is the order in which he's going to deploy it. We're going to test it out. So if that's the case, then it seems that the grenadiers are going to be first, and if the grenadiers are going to be first, we don't want the clustering buildings in the front, because that's going to make them, actually, we just want one. I just want this cluster building right here, and I don't want these two. I do want the other ones. The same for this one. I don't want the one near the edge, because I don't want them to destroy the minefield. So let's take a look if that's the case. If that's the case, whoever wrote that comment, yeah, it seems that way. So whoever wrote that comment in the description, thank you. That was on point. So see, they're attacking the building, and so far none of the mines were destroyed, which is awesome. And boom, those those grenadiers just suffer the consequences. Warriors 2, Riflemen 2. So now you see here, the medics are bouncing back and forth, but it's too late for them. Most of their group died, and now they're going to follow that group, forgetting about the sukas, and just letting their sukas down. So now they're walking back, trying to heal whatever is in the front, but it's already too late, number one. Number two, now they're going to be the recipient of the fury of my defenses. There we go. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, there's still a couple grenadiers alive. And the last medic should come down now. All right. So last medic is down. Let me accelerate this. We got away for Rifleman on the right side, just making his approach on the back side of the base. Rocket launcher should make short work of them. And then we all we have left are Grenadiers. Without medics, they have no chance. So, that was stage number what? Stage number five? Really? That fast? Stage number four. All right. So what is he attacking us with now? So he's attacking us with Sukas, Riflemen, Medics, and Grenadiers. So now that we know that trick about the order of where the troops are, we are going to reload our base back to normal. Back to normal. And then we are going to move this rocket launcher now into the inside of the cluster. We want it on the inside of the cluster. Grenadiers are going to be last. So, yeah. All right. Let's do this. This should be easy peasy. So, Sukas are first. So, guys, we learned something today. Thank you again for that comment. That makes the guesswork a lot easier. Ah, so Sukas decided to split like super crazy. All right, so he had barrage. Oh my god, he barraged one rocket launcher, and sniper tower and a boom cannon. Jeez, that's not good. All right, so stage five. It shouldn't be hard. Oh yeah, those two shock launchers and two rocket launchers amped up. There's no chance. Medics cannot outheal that. Oh, look at all those grenadiers on that side. That is gonna be crazy. Like, we have to, our defenses have to go quickly and hurry and destroy those medics. Cannot let those medics live. All right, so 3 out of 10. That's a good kill ratio. Let's accelerate this. All right, so those grenadiers are dead. Now we need to ensure that those guys just get destroyed. Come on. Don't let the rocket launcher get destroyed. Oh no. All right, we got this now. Come on, me, bro. Nice. All right. This one was a little bit harder. So maybe force everybody to go to the right and then leave that minefield so that the grenadiers on the right side destroy them. The mine destroys the grenadiers. All right. So that was stage five. Stage five was close. I'm not gonna lie. All right, so mainly because he destroyed one of our rocket launchers. All right, so let's take a look at stage six. So he's attacking us with tanks, 9 tanks, 192 riflemen, 32 grenadiers, 60 Sukas, and 64 warriors. This might be difficult, but we're not gonna change our base. We're gonna go for it. Let's see what happens. And then we'll do some modifications if we have to. So a sniper tower, no, boom cannon and a sniper tower, but he took away a flamethrower too and a machine gun. Not very good. So now we have tanks and riflemen. I would much rather deal with one set of them. All right. HotPot should be coming online very soon. We're running out of things to defend with, so this is looking like a loss. Yeah, this is going to be definitely a loss. So I didn't see what he was barraging out. Um, I didn't see. Let's take a quick look at what he was barraging out. See if we can figure that out and then repeat this stage. Just put this low. All right, so he's barraging that flamethrower. He's barraging the boom cannon and the sniper tower next to it. Alright, let's see, what else did he barrage? Did he barrage something else? Alright, so, and he barraged the rocket launcher and the thing left to the rocket launcher. Okay, so we're gonna switch a couple things. We're going to switch this flamethrower out, because we don't need him. And then he barrage this, and this, if I'm not mistaken. And then he barrage this mortar on the second wave. He barrage that mortar with the rocket launcher. Let's move the rocket launcher to the side. This got brushed last, so let's move it here, and then let's move this one to the front. I always like to leave some space just in case, yeah, for some reason the structure manages to survive. Okay. So now let's replace that machine gun there with, or the flamethrower with this. Let's move the boom cannons to the front. Let's see if we can guide those tanks in the first wave of grenadiers to this side, so that we can focus on the second wave on this side of the map. Okay, this should work. Now, we're actually gonna need the boom cannons on the back, because if we're driving everybody on the back side, we're gonna need that. So let's move this flamethrower here, to the front. Let's move this other flamethrower here to the front too. Let's see, what do we have? This flamethrower on this side. Let's move this cannon here, protected by this sniper tower, and then here. Okay. Let's try this now. Let's see what happens. All right, so we got the initial artillery barrage. Good. So, oh no, I forgot to put something on the middle. Wasting a spot. Alright, the first redirect worked. Everybody's going towards the... what did I miss? Shoot, it was a cannon instead of the... Alright, the rocket launcher survived, but those grenadiers are wrecking our day. So we need to do something about that. So there was a cannon. That I misplaced. The other thing we need to do is we need to move those shock launchers to the point where the grenadiers have range. That way, those grenadiers are gonna get destroyed. Let me watch the replay really quickly again. And then look at where those grenadiers parking. Okay, so here we go. Where are those grenadiers parked? Alright, so just at the edge. So the first thing is we need to move this cannon out. This cannon has served no purpose if it's gonna get GBE. Let's start putting stuff in. Okay, so all the grenadiers are gonna be in that area. So what we wanna do is we're gonna have all these mines right there. So when they come in, they get all wrecked. We're gonna have all those trucks mined there too. We wanna stop them on their tracks. Alright. We don't wanna give them a chance to start loving their. Alright, so then the other thing is we want to have those disc shocks launchers in range so that when they start firing, at least one of them. So that when they start firing, they can get shocked right away. Alright, now let's move what do we wanna move? Let's move this here. Actually, yeah, that's here because then we'll, there we go. Alright. Let's try this now. Should be, if I don't beat it on this time, I'll pause and then resume it once I manage to find it. That way you're not waiting. I'm gonna speed this up. That way you're not waiting for to see this. Or maybe you're interested in the logic process and how to defeat the stage, but awesome. We capture all the barrages. Rocket launcher managed to survive. Come on, Chuck. Fire, Chuck, fire. Not to the front. Wait, we get another barrage? That's freaking insane. How many barrages is he gonna send? This is like the last stage. This is just like the last stage. Why am I doing this in super slow speed? I don't know. This is even worse. Yeah, this is even worse. All right, let's speed this up. All right, what I'll do is I'll pause this after this one and then I'll resume it when I come back, when I get a solution. So I'll see you in a little bit. All right, so it took me several attempts to get it right. The first thing was to move the shock launchers to the front, move these buildings right here to somewhere else. That way the grenadiers were forced to come into that minefield in from the front, and then get wrecked by the shock launcher, rocket launcher combination, and the mines. Then on the right side, the tanks were coming in, so it was just a matter of splitting a little bit more the defenses here so that the grenadiers would split up and they would be easier to target. It would be an easier target for us to pick. And number two, it would be harder for them to do a lot of splash damage to other defenses. So let's take a quick look at what I did for stage two. So it took me 6 attempts to get stage six done. So let's take a look. All right, so that initial barrage is destroying two defenses. He actually sends 1, 2, 3. He sends 7 barrages, if I'm not mistaken. So that's 6 in total now. And he's gonna send two more for the rocket launcher on the top, so he sends 8. There you see the minefield and the boom mines coming into play. Rocket launcher, it's wrecking them. So there you see the other two barrages, so he sends 8 in total. This is pretty much like the last stage. In any case, our defenses in the front have survived. We have lost one because of the barrage, but wires are coming in. I mean, they're getting burned by the hot pot. That rocket launcher survived for a little bit, but it was destroyed. Now we get the final wave of warriors and riflemen. Hopefully, well, I know that the hot pot comes and burns them all. So now we have the tanks and the grenadiers engaging the rest of my defenses. Now, here's a good thing of trying to split up a little bit the defenses. Now the tanks are looking in different directions. I have two shock launchers, which are going to save the day. Two rocket shock launchers are going to save the day in combination with the rocket launcher, because they're keeping everything under stasis, everything nice and shocked. The cannons can pick the tanks one by one. And now that there are no more tanks, the grenadiers are vulnerable. 2 or 3 shocks from each of the boosted shocks are able to take them out. There was one last grenadier that just got burned, and boom. Stage 6 was done. I'm pretty sure that this combination is going to work, so make sure. I'm going to show it again here so you can see it. Okay, let's go back here. So that's how it looked. All right, let's see what is he. Remember to pause it if you're interested in copying this design. He's attacking with, okay, so let's go back to our regular base. Attacking with a lot of, he's attacking with lots of riflemen, grenade, what is it? Riflemen, tanks, and zookas. So this stage should not be hard at all. Now, riflemen are coming first, so that's good. Let's go for it. Let's go for the final set of defenses. Actually, he sent tanks first, or maybe he sends he landed the riflemen, but they came out in a single wave. Oh, I forgot to move the rocket launcher into the. Into the amped area. Are we gonna lose this because of that? I surely hope so. Hope not. Oh yeah, those tanks are toast. Look at that tank melting. Boop, that hot pot just killed 2 tanks. No, hot pot. All right, so we're gonna have to repeat this one because that shocked on the cannon essentially shocked our hot pot, and that was not good. The other thing that we want to do, we want to move the cannons forward so that they have a little bit better range. Now, I wasn't paying attention to whether or not what was the GBE targeting. So we're just gonna make those 2 slight changes for now. We're gonna make those 2 slight changes for now and then call it good. So what was the first thing? So was it this one or this one? I wanna say it was this one. So this thing was getting shocked. So let's move it here. Let's move this cannon here to the front. Let's move this other cannon here too. And let's move this other cannon here. So now we have everything here on the front. And what was the other thing I wanted to do? Let's actually move this here and this here too. I want to shock those guys as they come in and move the rocket launcher into position. That's the other thing I wanted to do. All right, this should be plenty enough. Let's move these mines outside because we know that Tsukas are coming. We want to catch them with their pants down. All right, so let's try this again. Oh yeah, so he's targeting with GBE two rocket launchers, the two rocket launchers and the boom cannon, which is crazy. All right, now with the cannons in the front, those guys are gonna go quicker. So yeah, I think they're gonna get destroyed even before the second wave arrives, which is awesome. Come on, target those things. Okay, so that's one tank less. All right, so we're good now. We lost our rocket launchers now. Come on, don't lose the pot. Shoot. How are those Tsukas still alive? How much boost health does they have? That's pretty insane if you ask me. Losing that hotpot cost us. We needed a hotpot alive. We need those tanks to die quicker. All right. So in order to make that happen, moving cannons and boom cannons into the front. That's what we need right now. We're gonna need this flamethrower here, this thing right here. Now this was the cannon that was getting hit, so let's move it outside of range. Let's move this to MGS somewhere here, that way they can target those Tsukas as they come up. And this bunch up. Alright, let's try this again. And again, if I fail on this attempt, what I'll do is I'll pause the recording and then come back. And come back once I find a solution. That way you don't have to keep watching the video. The video is already, it says 47, but that's with the pause time on. Now seems that it's a lot better, so we'll see. Hopefully those Tsukas do not target my hotpot now. Come on, kill them. All right, so I'll pause it after this one, and then I'll come back to you guys once I get the solution. Oh, no, we won. I was frustrated. I thought we wouldn't get it, but we got it. It's awesome. We got stage 7, guys. Very little modification. Think about what we got it on the second attempt. We tried two times and then we got it on the third one. So that's a winning solution right there, guys. So Yeah, I want to thank you for stopping by. If you like the content of the video, please click that subscribe button that's just below the icon that appears on the screen, on the left side of the screen. There's a couple videos or playlists that you might like on the right side of the screen. So please check those out. Smack the like button. Guys, thanks for stopping by and solid checking out.